Ready to go.
Mayor Nenshi, on the potential Olympic bids, did today just essentially free up enough money until the next office?
Yes, that's right. So what I really heard clearly from members of council is they didn't want to kill this. They wanted to move forward, but they also really understand that one of the really critical things is we're going to need all three orders of government, federal, provincial, and municipal, to agree to move forward, and they didn't want to get too far down that road until we got a sense from the other two orders of government where they're at. I have to stress something. This is going to be a mutual decision between the three orders of government on whether or not to move forward. I don't want either of the other two levels to be seen as an enemy here. We've worked well with them. And I would just like to continue to make sure that all three of us agree that this is something we want to do.
But does this essentially put pressure on the other two levels of government to basically put up or shut up?
It's not our intent to be bullying about this whole thing, but timelines are the timelines. And I think they are well aware that they're going to have to make some decisions by the end of the year, or they're just going to run out of runway, they won't have enough time. So I don't think the council did anything today that they don't already.
Well, it seems something more and more updated, the outcome is predetermined and we're decided.
Now you get to hear my speech. You know, we have taken a very thoughtful, and if you like, very risk-averse approach. We've taken a very thoughtful, if you like, a very risk-averse position on the entire thing. And so someone in CBEC said to me last week, you know, you've been so focused on the off-ramps. Could you build an on-ramp? Could you actually remind Calgarians why we want to dream big and why this is a project that really could make a ton of sense for Calgary? And I really recognize that because as the guy who's been asking for more and more and more
data,
I really did want to say, look, let's open up our thinking to say, yeah, this $2 million that we're being asked to spend or $1 million into the province of the feds are in is a risk. You know, unlike the money we spent before where there were tangible things like a facilities plan that is helping us move forward as a city on many other things, this is a real risk. And we may end up not bidding, or there may be a small possibility that we did and we lose the bid. But are we willing to take that risk to do something that could be incredibly special for Calgary? And I think that's really where the councillors ended up. Everyone has lots of questions, everyone got lots of concerns, but in the end, overwhelming majority of council said, you know what, let's take the risk. And let's see if we can bring our partners on board and if we can use this time and this money to craft something that could be very, very special for the city.
Thank you very much.
It's incredibly complex that the accounting of both the what putting on against costs and what the benefits are. But there are a lot of
yellow hardware that
shows it. It is pretty separated. How do you kind of separate the excitement that maybe councillors feel about being feeling responsible for putting on this great party, the great spectacle, with the need to be responsible and disciplined about not putting that on the better?
That's exactly right. We're being incredibly prudent about this. We're being really driven by data in a way that other big cities have never done. And also been very public. And you heard, for example, Councillor Farrell today say, as skeptical as she is about it, she's going to make sure that as we move on, we make sure we're very thoughtful about the benefits to the city, and I think we all feel that way. And so, yeah, we did not do any economic studies that barred up the benefits. We hired two very conservative economic groups to do a very conservative analysis of what they thought the cost benefits would be, and then the city hired two even more skeptical people to try and blow holes in that conservative analysis to make sure that we're really, really covering our bases. In the end, we have to make sure that we're prudent, that we're not wasting money, and that what capital money we're spending is ultimately going to create a legacy, an economic and a social legacy for the city. And those are the questions we will ask before we actually formally become a candidate city.
You mentioned that you're going to be paying the fence for years. What do you hope to get from her
in terms of the commitment? Well, she and I actually have a lot to talk about, so we're going to sit down on a whole whack of topics from the city charter to changes to the energy sector, as well as hopefully have an opportunity to talk about this. And I'll express to her that, you know, while we don't want to put any pressure on the three orders of government, we do have to make a decision by the end of the year on how we're going to fund this big committee.
Mr. Ripley indicated the feds would pay up to 35%. Are you looking for lower percentage.
You know, ideally I'd love to see a one-third split on the bid. Understanding the city has already spent a chunk of its one-third. The feds, it's a bit weird. It's 35% of the total cost, but 50% of total government costs. So there's a little room to play there. I think it means that if there was a lot of private sector funding in there, they would pay up to a third of, or 35% of the total. But if it's all government funded, they'll pay up to 50% of the total. I think that's what that means. I got to read the policy. So all I'm trying to say is there's probably a bit of room to play there between the three orders of government, but it has to be a partnership between us.
On what point do you say to corporate Calgary or Canada that they want to pitch it?
You know, that's already started. The CBEC folks have really good connections with corporate Calgary and corporate Canada, really. And there are some logistical challenges to raising money from the private sector just because of how the sponsorship works. But I suspect the private sector has been very enthusiastic, and we received well over $1 million in donations in kind and services in kind from private companies in the last round with CBEC, and so people have been very generous, and I hope they'll continue to be so. Well, Limon, il y a des questions, et mes collègues ont beaucoup de questions. Mais au fin, on a dit qu'il y a un rêve pour Calgary. Et ça fait du sens de prendre un petit peu de risque pour achever ce rêve.
Par rapport aux différents avis du gouvernement aussi.
C'est vraiment important que c'est vraiment une partnership entre les trois ordres du gouvernement. Et c'est important pour le gouvernement fédéral et le gouvernement d'Alberta de vraiment dire maintenant s'ils veulent faire partie de notre rêve. Okay? Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.